isolation station.
Hello, hello, hello. Welcome one and all to the show. It's 7 p.m. It's National Chocolate Covered Raisin Day. I'm George Lawton and this is Isolation Station. Huge thanks to Archimana's fabulous show as always. He'll be back tomorrow at 6 p.m. Get in touch over at isolation_radio on Instagram. As always, I'll be taking requests during the show, so do get involved. Tell me what you're having for tea or which family member you're close to inflicting violence upon. But for now, as we face day number one of Bojo enforced lockdown, from the bottom of my heart, I wish you all very well. It's Wish You Well, Sagala and Becky Hill. What a transition.
It's sad we're not together, but I wish happiness for you. I know we said forever, love don't always make it through. Sometimes even the good things get lost along the way. We opened up the same book but found a different page. Cause honesty, your loyalties, insecurities and priorities ain't the same. For harmony, it's the only thing I can say. I wish you well, I wish you well.
True Becky Hill story for you. I actually saw Becky perform live at a Cambridge University May Ball last year. I'm an exceptionally well-connected human. We're all grooving along to some Becky classics, dancing with one hand, port and cheese in the other. Then she stopped the music. Said, excuse me, let's stop this, please. She proceeded to berate the poor man filming her on stage beside her, stating, this is my space, get out. So, Becky, this one's for you.
Please don't stop the music.
But now we're rocking.
Hannah, please don't stop the music. I won't. I will keep it playing. For another 4 seconds. Until the track ends.
Please don't stop the music.
Isolation Station.
Now, we received news last night from the Ply Minister. He's the Minister of all things plywood. The Prime Minister, no less. That we would be allowed outside for things like basic necessities and exercise. But only once a day. And I think it's safe to say that it would be an understatement to describe what followed as a Twitter whirlwind. And I'm totally with everyone. Exercise once a day? Are you mental? Thanks, Boris, but I think I'll be sticking to my strict regime that I've built up over the past few days of no exercise and a good helping of Tesco's baked-in-store cookies. Perhaps with a scoop of Haagen-Dazs on a cheat day. So in a response to all of this, Mike Ashley, you know the guy, the worst fella the UK's ever birthed. Think Muggle Voldemort. Anyway, he issued a statement saying that he'd be keeping his stores, both Sports Direct and Evans Cycles, open. He claims that both of his stores offer public essentials. Now, I might be wrong, but when I tuned into the BBC last night, I don't recall the quote from Boris being, yeah, you can leave the house for food from Tesco, medicine from your pharmacy, and a golf umbrella from Sports Direct. Following the backlash today, they've issued another statement saying that they will, in fact, be closing. But look, I think it's only fair that Ashley should be allowed to keep his stores open. But if he succeeds in completing a task, and given he seems to be obsessed with the necessity of the British exercising, I think it would only be fair for it to be a physical challenge, right? So here's what I'm thinking. Mike Ashley can keep his stores open if he can successfully complete 5 press-ups in front of the nation to Kylie Minogue.
You ain't getting your girl what you need.
Kylie Minogue, get out of my way. It's what Karen said when she was trying to get the toilet roll from Tesco.
Isolation Station.
Now, before Kylie, we were talking about exercise during lockdown. Specifically, Retail's Voldemort Mike Ashley. But if there's one person that has emerged from this whole debacle as a knight in shining armour, it's got to be fan of the show, Joe Wicks. So, Joe Wicks, all-round buff fella, healthy-eating dude, exercise aficionado. He started streaming every morning for half an hour, doing a PE lesson for all the family, so that everyone can stay fit in their living rooms, essentially ruining the fun of isolation for literally everybody. Cheers, Joe! But never mind my personal anger at the fella. He's been receiving a solid 1 million viewers every day, which actually is a similar sort of figure to those tuning into Isolation Station, as it happens. Franz Ferdinand, Take Me Out. Now, I think we've actually just got a proper scoop. Fan of the show, James, an actual person that works in retail, has said that Mike Ashley has started putting up things in sports track by more than 50%. Thanks for the scoop, James.
Sleepless nights at the chateau. Visualize it. I'll give it something to do. crunch, crunch, wherever we go. Visualize it,
I'll give you something to do.
Galantis, peanut butter jelly. I wonder what that would have been called if it had been made in the UK. Marmite cheese cranberry?
Isolation Station.
Now then, with most of the nation now working from home, it's safe to say that productivity is likely to hit rock bottom. And I'm not just saying that out of speculation. I got figures. And what more evidence do you need than the fact that Nintendo Switches are pretty much sold out across the country? Last time I checked, Linda from Accounts does not need the latest Mario Kart console in order to input exchange rate data into Excel. I even saw a friend's story on Instagram a couple of days ago where he drove 75 miles to the closest Argos that stocked a Switch. Insanity. So, bar levels of productivity that float around the nil region, working from home presents lots of challenges. Video conference calls, for example. If Mike Ashley were to invent a form of communication, it would be the video conference call. There's plenty of video conference call bingos floating around Twitter at the moment, and they are utterly brilliant. Just to name a few of the squares. Sound of someone typing furiously, possibly with a hammer. Talking about the weather in each participant's location. What else have we got? Dog barking. Oh, my personal favourite. Oh, sorry. No, go ahead. Go ahead. I was on a call this morning. I hope they're not listening. But a colleague joined extremely out of breath, stating, "Sorry, been Joe Wixing." Joe Wicks should never be used as a verb. We'll be right back. bohemian like you, Dandy Warhols. So what are your experiences of working from home? Are you enjoying the lack of irritating colleagues? Accounts, I'm looking at you. Got any bizarre video conference call tales? Let me know on Instagram at isolation_radio. Vampire Weekend Day Punk. Sorry, I've got some messages in from people working in accounts that aren't very happy, including my auntie. Sorry, Auntie Claire. You're great. It's just Linda from accounts. Dreadful. If you're enjoying the show, do get in touch over at isolation_radio on Instagram. We'll be right back. She sells Sanctuary the Cult. That was a request for from Nicola Sturgeon there. Oh no, sorry, I am looking at my notes. No, it was my dad, actually. Nicola is a fan of the show, though, notoriously.
Isolation Station.
Now, whenever there is a big news story around, you can bet on the fact that there'll just be as much fake news swimming around there as there is real news. And it can often be quite difficult to tell those facts from fiction, especially if they're presented by sites and accounts that have been built to look genuine. The Daily Mail, for instance. We've all seen your nan's best mate, Pat, share a status from a qualified Chinese doctor, stating that we can rid ourselves of the virus by drinking water, which washes the virus into our stomach where it's dissolved. I'm not going to waste my breath on that, but all I'm saying is that it may be a good idea for some parents to sit in on their children's online biology lessons. Now, fake news is one thing, but memes are another. We've all seen edited photos of news reports which show something utterly ridiculous, you know, something like a T-Rex that's just escaped from Colchester Zoo. Well, it seems like some of the older Twitter generation are finding it a little tricky to distinguish between these clearly fabricated jokes and real-life news. There's been one going around over the past couple of days which states, "Breaking news. Vladimir Putin unleashes more than 500 lions onto Russia's streets to ensure that people are staying indoors during this pandemic." It's even got a picture that goes with it. I had a good laugh. I love how it specifically states that Putin did it too. I'm just imagining him going around to all the zoos and personally shooing them out of their enclosures. But here's the thing. It seems that Lord Alan Sugar didn't quite understand the joke. You know Alan Sugar, the billionaire one. Well, he retweeted the photo with a caption, "Is this a wind-up? Oh, Alan. Beautiful, gullible Alan. You're fired."
You would not believe your eyes if 10 million fireflies lit up the world as I fell asleep. Everywhere you'd think me rude, but I would just stand and stare. 'Cause I get 1,000 hugs from 10,000 lightning bugs as they tried to teach me how to dance. A foxtrot above my head, a sock hop beneath my bed, a disco ball is just hanging by a thread.
Hard to say that I'd rather stay awake when I'm asleep. 'Cause It's hard to say that I'd rather stay awake when I'm asleep, because my dreams are bursting at the seams.
Isolation Station.
Right. Now, I've just this second found this really interesting thing on the really sort of high-tech studio environment that I'm in. There's a little tab on the broadcaster I'm using where I can see where people are listening from. So, hold the line. Let me go see who we've got. We've got some people from Stoke-on-Trent. That's probably my nan. We got Cambridgeshire. We've got the Wirral, West Sussex. But then we got Germany. Who's listening from Germany? And we got someone from Ireland. We're reaching far and wide here. So where are you calling? Where are you calling? Where are you listening from? Let me know on Instagram at @isolation_radio. But anyway, enough of that nonsense. Just buckle up, everyone. It's show 5. And we're at absolutely no risk of running out of Shrek bops anytime soon. That's right, it's Shrek's egg time. It's that part of the show where I play the best music that iTunes has to offer. The real cream of the crop. And for that, you do not need to look any further than the Shrek 1, 2, or 4 soundtracks. Don't talk to me about Shrek the Third, or I will throw you out of a window. So, you all know the drill. Turn the king into a frog, discuss the anatomy of an onion, and take a walk to Funky Town.
Talk about it.
Yeah, scream if you want to go faster. Yeah, the Dodgems are now £1.50 for the rest of the night. Go see Julie in the corner. She's got candy floss. Disco Inferno. The Traps. Yeah, this is George's Funfair Radio. No idea what that was all about. It won't happen again. It might. Nah, probably not. Right then.
Good news.
Sorry, just trying to find the good news. Has anyone seen it? I'm sure I had it here somewhere. Ah, here it is. Just because there's... good news can be a bit harder to find at the minute. Doesn't mean it doesn't exist. Just got to look a bit harder for it. GCSE drama coming in handy with that little bit there, I tell you. Whoa. So I've started a good news segment where every show I share some good news with you. Today's good news comes in the form of a video from Reddit. Thanks to Katie for sending this one in. Now it gets to that sort of part of the day where I'm planning the show. And I just can't be bothered anymore. I love planning it, don't get me wrong. But the good news can be quite difficult to find. So I asked my friend Katie to do it for me. And without fail, she always delivers. The last four shows, all four, have been good news sourced by her. I've got to say, we did struggle a little with this one. I was going to pretend it was from now, but it is kind of from August last year. But I'm sure similar things are happening now. We can pretend. So anyway, the video shows some bin men in the UK knocking on the door of a lady called Mercy, who's celebrating her 100th birthday. They surprise her with a cake, sing to her, and ask her to blow out the candles. Let's have a listen.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Mercy. Happy birthday to you. Hey!
You're
all right.
You
going to
blow them out?
Oh, you'll have to take me.
Make a
wish.
Oh,
I
should
live to 105.
Shut up.
What a video. I mean, I suggest you go and watch it, because it's not quite the same without the video component, but you get the idea. But I think we can all take something from that. It really is the little things that can mean the most to people.
I heard it on the radio on my way back home that I'm gonna be someone. I guess it was a song they wrote saying don't go slow, cause you're gonna be someone. They were singing hallelujah, hallelujah. I heard it on the radio on my way back home. Some days I don't think my mama thinks I'm good enough to be a superstar. But one day I will show her I'm a diamond in the rough, I'll be a superstar. Cause there's a crown covered in glitter and gold. I'm gonna wear it, whether you like it or not. Yeah, there's a crown covered in glitter and gold. I'm gonna wear it, whether you like it or not. And I'll be singing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Was a request from me. One of my all-time favourites, that Oh Wonder, Hallelujah. Isolation Station. Well, that's show five, ladies and gentlemen. Another huge thank you from my bedroom to everyone that's tuning in. Whether today's your first show or you're a veteran Isolation Station listener. Archie Manners will be back tomorrow with special guest Jack Maynard, you know, like the famous one. But as always, I'll be back tomorrow night at 7 p.m. I do genuinely hope that this show is succeeding in its goal of putting a smile on your faces. Now, let's finish with a song that never fails to make me smile. It's Elbow.
kiss me like we died tonight. Holy calories, and only now I see the light. Yeah, lying with you half away. Oh, anyway, it's looking like it. Kiss me when my lips are thin. 'Cause holy cow.
Day like this, Elbow. Thanks so much, everyone, for tuning in once again. I'll be back tomorrow at 7 p.m. Thank you to all the listeners, and also my dad for just bringing me up a glass of Prosecco. Very kind. Remember, wash your hands and stay inside, unless you're using that one exercise coupon, in which case, go wild.
Isolation Station.